Microlecture 17, The French Revolution. The French Revolution had its immediate origins in the financial difficulties of the government. Louis XV and its ministers' failed attempt to raise taxes to finance the Seven Years' War had terrible consequences. When the attempt to raise taxes failed, the government was forced to borrow money to finance its enormous spending. As a result, the national debt soared and the nation was on the verge of bankruptcy. A meeting of the States General was called in May 1789. The States General was a legislative body of 12,000 representatives from the three orders of society, the clergy, the nobility, and commoners, who gathered together in an atmosphere of deepening economic crisis. Arguments about voting procedures almost immediately deadlocked the meeting of the States General. The government insisted that each state should meet and vote separately. But most people believed that was unfair with the popular classes because the nobles had more power despite being a tiny overprivileged minority. The issue came to a crisis in June 1789 when delegates of the State General refused to meet until the king ordered the clergy and nobility to sit with them in a single body. A few parish priests began to go over to the States, which on June 17 vowed to call itself the National Assembly. On June 20, delegates of the Assembly swore the famous Oath of the Tennis Court, pleading not to disband until they had been recognized as a National Assembly and had written a new constitution. The king's response was erroneous. While he claimed that he accepted people's demands, he also sent the army to dismantle and control the National Assembly. On July 14, 1789, hundreds of common people, angered by the king's action, stormed the Bastille, a royal prison, and the popular rebellion began. The National Assembly responded to the popular mobilization with a decree that, in August 4, 1789, abolished all the nobles' privilege along with the tithes paid to the church. On August 27, 1789, the Assembly further issued a Declaration of the Rights of Man and of the Citizen. The declaration guaranteed equality before the law, representative government for a sovereign people, and individual freedom. The text was quickly disseminated through France, the rest of Europe, and around the world. Over the next 2 years, the liberal revolution consolidated. In June 1790, the National Assembly abolished the nobility, and in July, the king swore to uphold the as-yet-unwritten constitution. The king remained at the head of the state, but all lawmaking power now resided in the National Assembly, elected by the wealthiest half of French males. The constitution finally passed in September 1791 was the first in French history. It legalized divorce and broadened women's rights to inherit property and obtain financial support for illegitimate children from fathers, but excluded women from political office and voting. The deputies prohibited monopolies, guilds, and workers' associations and abolished barriers to trade within France. Thus, the National Assembly applied the spirit of the Enlightenment in a throughout reform of France's laws and institutions. The National Assembly also transformed religious life by granting free cult and gave Jews and Protestants equal rights. In November 1789, it nationalized the property of the Catholic Church and abolished the monasteries. The outbreak and progress of the revolution in France produced great excitement and a sharp division of opinion in Europe and the United States. Liberals and radicals saw a triumph of liberty over despotism, while conservative leaders were deeply troubled by the aroused spirit of reform. Different kings and nobles in Europe, who at the beginning saw the revolution as an opportunity to weaken one of its historical competing powers, began to worry and fear its impact once they recognized the possibility of experiencing a similar process. In June 1791, the royal family was arrested and returned to Paris after a failed attempt to escape France. The royal house in Austria and Prussia saw that arrest as unacceptable and tried to intervene in France to restore Louis XVI's rule. The new French representative body, called the Legislative Assembly, was dominated by members of the Jacobin Club, one of the many political clubs that had formed to debate the most critical social issues of the day. This assembly believed that the Europeans' power intrusion was a danger and decided to mobilize people to the capital and imprison the king. The fall of the monarchy marked a rapid radicalization of the revolution. In late September 1792, a new assembly, called the National Convention, was elected by universal manhood suffrage. The convention proclaimed France a republic, a nation where the people, instead of the monarch, held sovereignty and power. Under the leadership of Maximilien Robespierre and Georges-Jacques Danton, the convention tried and convicted the king for treason. On January 21, 1793, Louis was executed. His wife Marie Antoinette suffered the same fate later that year. Despite the fall of the monarchy, the organization of the republic proved to be problematic and challenging. There were conflicts with the other European powers and struggles between political factions within the movement. These events are known as the Reign of Terror, because those who did not agree with the republican values were accused of being enemies of the nation. As a result, some 40,000 French men and women were executed or died in prison. The French Revolution was a definitive moment in modern history. It set the basis for the republican era in Europe and in many other parts of the world. Despite its widespread violence, the revolution's central ideas of freedom, legality, and equality continue to be at the center of democratic ideals today. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.